Hello everyone, and let's check out another instructive chess game from the history of chess. And in this chess game, white is Mikhail Botvinnik, and his opponent is Paul Keres. The legendary Paul Keres. And this game was played in 1948 in the FIDE World Chess Championship Tournament. After the death of Alexander Alekhine in 1946, they made a tournament to decide who is the world chess champion. And who won this tournament? Well, Mikhail Botvinnik won the tournament and became the world chess champion in 1948 until 1963. In this time period, Mikhail Botvinnik lost his title 2 times and he regained his title in the return matches and defeated his opponents like Vasily Simislov and Mikhail Tal. And he regained his title for 2 times. But finally he lost his title in 1963 to Tigran Petrosyan. And he never won the title once again. So let's check out how this game went on from 1948. Mikhail Botvinnik has the white pieces and his opponent Paul Keres has the black pieces. Botvinnik starts the game with playing d4, knight to f6, c4. And we basically have the Nimzo Indian defense, bishop to b4, c3, castling a3, capturing the knight, bishop takes on c3, capturing back, rook to e8, knight to e2, e5, knight to g3, d6, bishop to e2, knight from b to d7, and also Botvinnik castled, c5, f3, by Botvinnik, c takes on d4, capturing back, c takes on d4, knight to b6, bishop to b2, e takes on d4, and e4 by Botvinnik, not capturing the pawn. He doesn't want to open the e-file for his opponent. Bishop to e6, attacking the pawn, defending with the rook, rook to c1, rook to e7, and finally Botvinnik captured the pawn. And with the bishop, Mikhail Botvinnik is targeting on g7. And this doesn't look very safe for Paul Keres. As you can see, queen to c7 by Paul Keres, attacking the c-pawn, how to defend? Well, Botvinnik played the best move and he pushed the pawn, c5. And this is looking annoying for Paul Keres. Also attacking the knight, so Keres captured the pawn. But then, rook takes on c5, attacking the queen, defending, attacking again, bishop to c1, going back, and then, what would you do? Well, rook to g5, of course, targeting on g7 again, and at the same time, Botvinnik is threatening to capture the knight. As the g-pawn is pinned, how to defend? Knight from b to d7, defending by Paul Keres. Can you guess the next move of Botvinnik? And now, this is the key moment of this chess game. What would you do in this position? It is white to move, and can you guess the killer move? Botvinnik played a killer move, and after that move, Paul Keres is in big trouble. Botvinnik played rook takes on g7, sacrificing the rook. What a move! And Paul Keres captured the rook, and then knight to h5. Let's check again. The knight is pinned. We have king to g6 by Paul Keres. But what happens if going back? If king to g8, then capturing the knight. Check, capturing back, and queen takes on f6. Also attacking the rook. Let's say defending the rook, but then bishop to b2. And how to defend the checkmate threat? There is no defense. Let's say king to f8, the only defense. Cutting the escape square, rook to d1. So there is no reasonable defense in this position. a6 and queen to h8, king to e7, and bishop to f6. Checkmate. There is no defense. So this was the move. Rook takes on g7. Sacrificing the rook. And then, knight to h5 by Mikhail Botvinnik. This is check. King to g6. And now what? Botvinnik played queen to e3, threatening checkmate again. Queen to g5 or queen to h6. Check, mate. There is no defense. So this is why, after queen to e3, Paul Keres resigned. It was not very easy to defeat Paul Keres, especially this quickly. In a chess miniature like this, Mikhail Botvinnik crushed Paul Keres very quickly in this chess game. It is sharp attacking play. And let me show you the possible continuation. Well, of course, capturing the knight with the king is out of questions because of queen to g5, check, mate. So what now? The computer engine says that knight takes on e4 is the only defense in this position. And then queen to h6, that's check, king to f5, and knight to g7, that's check again, king to e5, rook to d1, cutting the escape square. And how to defend? Bishop to f4. Check, mate. There is no defense. So let's say queen to c7. A random move. Then bishop to f4. Check, mate. A beautiful chess game by Mikhail Botvinnik. Did you see rook takes on g7? Sacrificing the rook. And after king to g6, queen to e3 by Botvinnik. And basically, black is getting checkmated. There is no defense. There is forced checkmate. And thank you for watching. And I hope to see you next time. Take care and bye-bye.